fucking hat like I'm Gilligan. Hit Wallace, I just ordered a Cullinan. Milking the cow, what are you niggas uttering? Churning the butter, sensitive niggas crying. Stepping in puddles in the new Giannos, nigga. The team I'm assembling, you trembling. We in a circle, huddling, fumbling. We coming and tackling your empire. It's why...
Welcome to the full Derby Eaton video.
One numb, huh? Shit is humbling.
Hydrate before caffeinate, so typically wake up in the morning, have some Vasa, have some vitamin C, some multivits, some vitamin D3 and krill oil. No particular order. But again, then I'll have the Vasa, go Rosetta Stone, that is water. And then we have coffee. Today's macronutrients are 420 grams of carbs, 230 grams of protein and 50 grams of fat. Today is a diet break. Today is the penultimate day of my deload, and we all know what deloads are like.
Oh, boring.
Oh, boring. Boring. It's boring. Oh, that's boring.
So yeah, I'll go train and then we'll have our first meal.
And now guess what that was?
Boring.
Boring.
Circle huddling, fumbling, we coming and tackling your empire. It's robber crumbling. One numb, huh? Shit is humbling. I'm a fucking jumbotron, juggernaut. You a Jeep, no, you.
First meal of the day. Do you like my singing?
No.
2 scoops of this cinnamon donut. I had really high expectations for this. I had expectations that it's going to be a cinnamon donut in my mouth, but it's kind of like, it's not. Anyway, 2 scoops of this, 150 mils, I was going to say grams, but 250 mils of milk, and a trusty squares bar. So fitness, and their macros right there, are 35 grams of carbs, 7.6 grams of fat and 47.4 grams of proton. I wouldn't actually have any carbs with this meal. I'd just have 2 scoops of this and I wouldn't have this, but because we're diet breaking and we have slightly more food, I'm gonna have some carbohydrates. Say hi.
Hello.
Are you gonna say hi too? Say hi to the camera.
Not new balloon, watch it concave on the skateboard. Don't do surfboards, I don't ride waves. Been around forever, Murray's palm made, nigga. Been like a decade, yeah. Hey yo, keep it buck, I switch it up. You niggas don't, that's why you stuck. I need a 7 figures, hit Australia, pick it up. Find some young twink and get my
next meal. We have basmati rice, we have cooked chicken, barbecue chicken, and we have salad. We're also going to finish this off with the elegant Frenchie's mustard, and also some balsamic. They're the condiments of choice. But the macros for the meal are 60 grams of protein, nearly exactly actually, it's 59.9 grams of protein, I'll just call it 60, 9 grams of fat, 8.7, and 113.4 grams of carbohydrates, or 114 grams of carbohydrates. And that's meal number 2, and this is approximately 3 hours, 3 hours difference between meal 1 and meal 2. Peace, I'm going to enjoy this. We have just eaten that meal. When I say we, by the way, it was me. You didn't eat my meal. You were another meal. And I'm still a little bit peckish. And again, I can afford the calories today, so we're gonna have squares bar as well. See, it's just rice-based products. We had squares bar this morning, and then we had rice, and then carbs again, rice. It's easy to digest. Also, the macros for this squares bar are 3.4 grams of fat, 21 grams of carbs, and 0.8 grams of protein. Not enough to spike MPS, but not a very good hit at all. Okay, so between meals 2 and 3, I'm basically just going to run down all the supplements that I take throughout the day. I figured it's a full day of eating, I might as well just explain what kind of supplements I'm taking and when, right? So you obviously saw everything this morning. So I had the vitamin C, the multivit, the krill oil, and also vitamin D, right? So they're just my AM sups. Again, it just covers all bases in terms of kind of vitamins and minerals. You could probably get some of them from food sources, but vitamin D this time of year in the UK is quite poor, so supplementing there is fine. I don't actually eat fish, hence the krill oil. And then vitamin C and kind of multivit is just gonna cover us in terms of the vitamins and mineral panel. Now, before training or intra training, unless you do before training first, I would typically take some sort of non-stim pre or a stim pre, depending on if it's AM and PM. This morning I didn't actually take anything because I'm deloading, but typically I'll take either one of these two, so there, or and then I will mix that with 5 grams of creatine. So yeah, that's typically everything in the AM right there. And then intra workout, I will typically take some EAAs. I would actually recommend some Clearway as well. Again, I just need to run out of that tub. I don't really have it that much. I typically just take half a scoop because I'm actually just quite covered with my kind of nutrient timing. In terms of like daily beaters, so like maybe like the midway point or post-workout, I will basically have some of these or one of these, either one. Currently rotating between the two. So we have the Raw one and also the Perform Cinnamon Donut. So again, AM sups here, and then maybe like AM, PM, etc, etc. The timing of whey is not actually that important. I also, pre-work or kind of to add to my non-stim pre, I'll typically have some Alpha GPC and also some Huvazine. These are cognitive, or like a kind of a nootropic, so they do have some cognitive benefits. I have been having this kind of like post-workout, and when I'm about to do work, so typically I'll just work out in the morning, and then I will have these two. These two in conjunction have caused quite a thought process. And I am, again, deloading this week, so I do have like no caffeine in my system, so it'll be interesting to have these with caffeine and see what kind of the benefits are. Well, I'm hoping they'll be pretty damn good. The only thing with Huvazine, you should really cycle it. So I'm going to be quite sparing with that. And then moved on to the PM supplements and typically like sleep supplements. We have ashwagandha, magnesium biglycinate, the sleep stack, 5-HTP, and the trusty melatonin. Now, I don't actually take this every single day. I've recently added this in, just because it has some appetite suppressant qualities. I tend to take that with meal 4 or meal 5, depending on the day. Typically on a rest day or something like a deload, I'll only have 4 meals. So today I might have only 4 meals. But typically on a training day, I will normally have 5. So this is either with meal 4 or meal 5. And then half an hour after that meal, I will then go for the sleep stack, the ashwagandha, the magnesium biglycinate, and then sometimes the melatonin. It will just depend on either what day it is, life stress, etc. I don't necessarily take that every single day. So in terms of like daily supplements, I will probably throw that out and say these are all the daily supplements. Anyway, I'm gonna go do some work. I'm actually just about to have these. And then I'll see you in meal 3.
Hello. It's been a couple of hours since the last time I spoke, and it's been a couple of hours since meal number 2. This is going to be meal number 1, 2, 3. Meal number 3, and me and Natalie decided to have a takeaway. Now, I thought this would be a good opportunity, since it's a full day of eating, to show you how I would track specifically an Indian takeaway. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to dive into the old laptop, and I'll basically just show you how I would track it. Now, a couple of years ago, I would have kind of crapped myself at the thought of how the hell do I track this, etc., etc. But there's always something on a menu that would suit your needs. And if there isn't, then obviously you could probably say no. But for the most part, I would say that every single takeaway in the world would have something that you could probably fit in at a squeeze. So we're just going to dive into this. We are going to have a Kahani, which is an Indian that's just down the road, and we've actually just ordered it. And let me just see how many calories I do have. So I have around 1800 calories to play with, and I'm going to split that up between two meals. So I think as long as I nail maybe like 1,000 or 800 calories here, then I'm pretty covered. So things to watch out for: things like chicken wings, things like let's just say, here we go, chicken pakora, right? Smashed chicken sounds great, but then you look at what it's kind of coated in. It's coated in corn flour, deep fried. Now, very good in a kind of massing phase, and you could probably fit it in a fat loss phase. But like, do you need that? Probably not. So there's kind of just things to avoid. Onion bhajis, same thing, right? Anything that's kind of like deep fried, you most likely want to avoid in prep, but again, in a mass go ahead. So I have actually gone for, and let's go through kind of this, right? So most of the stuff with kind of an Indian, you'd associate maybe most stuff with like a masala, a korma. I think that's a korma. I think they maybe spelled it wrong. A korma, a pasandas, kind of all of these different things. Now, all of these in prep are maybe a no-go, right? Just because I just don't know what's inside it. So I can't really like account for anything, right? Again, in a massing phase, completely fine. But in a fat loss phase, you want to go for something like a grill. These are perfect, right? Like here, we've got like, this is the one that I've gone for. It's called the, I'm not even sure how to explain or to say that. But basically all it is kind of marinated chicken breast, chicken breast with coriander, mint, and green chilies. And all I'm going to have that with is going to be steamed rice. I know what's inside steamed rice. It's just rice, right? Again, that's my carbohydrate of choice. It's going to be a steamed rice and chicken. So basically all I'm going to have is chicken and rice, and I'm probably going to have some salad with it. But understand that, like, you do have to compromise at some point. Like maybe like poppadoms and chutneys, and probably not gonna have chips, and you're probably not gonna have like a peshwari naan, and you're probably not gonna have all of these different things. But understand that you can make things work. You just have to be a little bit savvy on it. So that's what I'm gonna do now. We're just gonna wait for that to come, and then we're gonna devour it, and then I'll put the calories when we get it. I'll put the calories on my guesstimated calories. But basically all I'll do when I get the chicken is basically weigh the chicken, which I know is around 270 because I've weighed it before, and I've weighed it earlier on in prep. So 270 to 280. And then I will weigh out the rice, because last time I did cook my rice. But yeah, that's all I do. Again, don't be kind of hard on yourself, and don't kind of feel really anxious with these sort of things. You don't need all of these kind of like the chicken pakoras. You don't need like bolty. You don't need all of these different things to have a nice meal. You can go for this quite easily, and it'd be kind of completely fine. So that's what I'm going to do. We're basically waiting for that, and then again I'll show you the calories. Sweet. You can eat out in prep. It's fine. Natalie, where are we going?
We are off to the takeaway.
We're going to get the takeaway. Yes, we are. Some people are so shit at driving, Natalie. Anyway, that's what we're doing. Hey, takeaway dance. Hey.
Get my nipples sucked. Bad yellow bitch look like pimple pus. Bad chocolate bitch look like nothing. Y'all got too much baggage. And I pack like Louis Trump. Luggage double C. Emeralds double V. You need tea, but the sweat.
Takeaway acquired. You excited?
Yeah.
Sick.
Versus me, lemonade, elderflower with the words. Sony read up, I'ma spit it with the bro. Yeah.
Okay, so because I don't know exactly how much rice I've got or chicken, what I'm gonna do is basically weigh it. So move this out of the way. We are gonna then put the rice on here, zero it off. Zero, and then just plonk it on
the plate. So here is like 258. So I'll call that 260 grams of rice. And we'll do the same to the chicken. Zero off. If I remember, it's 270. There's 316, but we do have a crap ton of onions, so I'll probably call that like 300 grams of chicken. I've also got some salad here as well. Niggas like at your age till you trip. We just finished that meal. Natalie, how was it? How was yours?
It was really good, but
can you fit in frame? Look how small you are in frame.
I have to be on my tippy toes, but I'm really full.
Wait, what did you have?
I had chicken tikka masala with rice.
Okay.
And naan bread.
Alright, well, I'm done with you. Right, okay, so not really sad. So I was just gonna go through the tracking of that meal. So I estimated at 90 grams of protein, 25.5 grams of fat, and 120 grams of protein. Now, what I did do is basically estimate everything. I obviously had the tracked chicken. I actually weighed the chicken after the fact and weighed the onion separately, and it actually came out to around 280 grams of chicken, and then we just put 300 grams of rice. So we basically increased our carbs a little bit. And also, I don't really know what it's cooked in, so I actually added 10 grams of fat to that meal. So that leaves us with around 600 calories for the end meal. That chocolate bitch look like Lionel. Knuckles, y'all got too much baggage, and I pack like Louis Trunk. Luggage double C, emeralds double V. Unity, but the sweater vest is me. Lemonade, elder flower with the world. Sony, read up, I'ma spit it with the bro. Yeah. Niggas like, act your age till you trippin'. Pushing 30, but the skin say different. Well, if I act my last deal, I'm probably 12. Niggas on, niggas set up live, then they hurt they self. And to finish the day off, or the day's macros, I don't know if you can see that, we have the goat cereal. And we also have one scoop of this, 150 milliliters of milk. And then we have the trusty squares bar. Ease in it. I'm just gonna get the macronutrients up. Macronutrients for this meal are 28 grams of protein, 9.2 grams of fat, and 70 grams of carbs. And that is the diet breakdown. I've got one more day of this and then back to normal calories. Weight is sitting nicely at 83.3, and we'll just see what it does over the next kind of couple of days. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next vlog. 30, but the skin say different. Well, if I act my last deal, I'm probably 12. Niggas on, niggas set up live, then they hurt.